So today, let's talk about impulse and momentum. And let's start with momentum. So when we say momentum class, this is all about mass in motion. So we have mass and it moves. So therefore, when it is in motion, it possesses velocity. And then in mathematical term, it is the product of mass and velocity. So its equation or formula is written by capital letter P. So momentum P is equal to the product of mass and velocity. So M, then velocity V. So class, unsa may expected na itong units sa atong momentum? Unsa man na ito ang units niini? Based sa ato ang mga given nga mga quantities, mass and velocity. So unsa man? Nama idea? What is the unit of the momentum? Okay, so since we have mass and we have velocity, so for mass, this is in kilogram, and then for velocity, that is in meter per second. So therefore, a momentum is in kilogram meter per second. And then momentum also is a vector quantity. Why? Because we have here the velocity, and we all know that velocity is a vector quantity. And of course, the principle of momentum can be applied on collision. Let's say two cars are colliding on the road. So we can analyze on which car travels faster than the other. Kay kung siya may kuan, so there's a higher chance nga siya may kuan, siya may sadan. So ma-analyze na to siya. Why? Because by looking at the formula for momentum, so we have mass, so the car possesses a mass, and then of course, since it is moving, so it has velocity. So the higher the mass, of course, the higher the momentum, because momentum is directly proportional with these two quantities, mass and velocity. So if you have higher velocity and you have a greater momentum, diba? If sa kuan, sa normal definition sa momentum is that, diba, kanang kuan ba, kanang namoy strong spirit to finish a certain task, kay kusog na inyong momentum ba mahuman ninyo or ma-achieve ninyo ang usa ka goal. So the same thing with mass. So if you are massive, bugat kay ka, and then you travel at a greater speed, so you have velocity and this is your mass. Now it is very difficult for this object M, very massive, to be stopped. Oh, lisod kay siya pugngan ngano man, because bugat kay siya, massive pa siya, and then it runs at a higher speed or higher velocity. So dako kay siya og kuan, dako siyang P, which is its momentum. So it would be very difficult for it to be stopped. So basically ingana ang kanang kuan momentum. So don't forget, momentum is the product of mass and velocity. So the higher, I mean, the massive you are, and also the faster you are, so you possess a higher value of momentum. So let's try to solve momentum problems. So since you know that momentum is mass times velocity, so here it states that determine the momentum of the following. So we have here the first one is this statement, the second is this, the third is this. So let's start with the first one. It states here that we have a 60 kilogram halfback. So this is an animal, halfback. So 60 kilograms, so we already have a mass of 60 kilogram. And then it states here that it moves eastward at 9 meters per second. So as what I have told you, you need to you need to include the direction of your motion, because velocity is a vector quantity. So here we can say that it moves eastward. So let's assume that we take positive if it moves to the east. Diba? In our compass, we have north, south, east, and west. So we need to initialize, or we need to initialize ang directions ato ang velocity. So natay convention ini nga, we take positive if it is on the east nga direction. So here we have a speed of 9 meter per second, or we can just take it as the velocity, 9 meter per second. So this is a positive velocity, since it moves or it travels to the east. So therefore, our resulting momentum is just equal to the product of the mass and velocity, that is equal to 60 times 9 meter per second. So that is 540 kilogram meter per second, and it moves to the east. So therefore, it has a greater momentum along towards the east, or towards the right. And then the second statement, it says that you have a 1,000 kilogram car. So you have the mass of your car, 1,000 kilogram, and then moving northward at 20 meter per second. So northward is upward, so we considered positive if it is upward or northward. So our velocity is 20 meter per second. So therefore, our resulting momentum is just the product of these two. So we have 1,000 multiplied by 20. So that would be 20,000 kilogram. That is not per meter. That is kilogram meter, because that is multiplication. So this is kilogram meter per second. Then it travels north. Okay, so this one possesses higher momentum. And then the third statement, 40 kilogram freshman, so taon is siya, moving southward at 20 meter per second. So again, you have a mass of 40 kilogram, and then southward naman siya, so it is negative, since we considered positive for upward motion or upward velocity. So our velocity here is already negative 2 meter per second. So again, why? Because it moves southward. So our momentum is just equal to the mass times velocity. Our mass here is 40 kilogram multiplied by the velocity of negative, so that is negative 80 kilogram meter per second. So what does this negative means or indicates? It means that you have a momentum on the south direction, or you can just take the positive, but be sure kilogram meter, that this is not per kilogram, this is kilogram meter. So that is kilogram, then meter per second, then you can just write there south. So if you indicate that one, so it's already kana siya kanang automatic na nga this momentum is negative. So they have a question so far, class, regarding with this. Actually, this is just the basic calculation for solving the momentum of a moving object. So naay a question so far. Wala. Okay. So another one. Let's try another example for momentum. Actually, this problem is only deals with a single object. So wala pa ta sa gitawag na collision. So single object ron siya nga nag-move. Kay momentum can also be used to analyze objects that are colliding or that are interacting with each other. Here, I'll just show to you some problems that only deals with a single object that is in motion. Because of course, if the object is in motion, then it has, or it possesses momentum. So here it states here that a car possesses 20,000 units of momentum. So again, 20,000 units. So we don't know, maybe this is in kilogram meter per second, or we have pounds feet per second. So units lang, wala indicate nga exact nga kuan, exact nga unit or dimension. So here, what would be the car's new momentum if its velocity was doubled? Okay. Since I mean for letter A, it states here that what would happen daw, or what is the new momentum? So we need to find P new, or the new momentum, and then the condition is if its velocity was doubled. So therefore, the velocity, the new velocity, is just equal to 2 times the previous velocity. And then we all know that the previous momentum, so diba, a previous momentum is equal to 20,000 units as stated by the problem, 20,000 units of momentum. And then this is also equivalent to mass times, of course, velocity, diba? So therefore, we can say that for the new momentum, so that is P nu, is equal to, of course, since same ramang gyapon ng object nga tong gitakold, still a car, of course mass here will not change, okay, same ramang object, so mass, but the velocity of course will change. That's why we put here vn, or the new velocity. And since the new velocity is just twice the previous velocity, as mentioned by the first requirement, which is its velocity was doubled daw, so we can write here m times 2v. And we all know, rearranging this, so we have 2 times mv. And since we have here the product of mv, or mass times velocity, is just 20,000. So that would be 2 times 20,000. Okay, it was written here, diba? This is our previous or initial momentum. So therefore, the new momentum will now be 40,000 units. So it means that if we are going to double the velocity, the resulting momentum would also get doubled. Why? Because they are directly proportional. So muna ang finding. And then the second one is, how about if its velocity was tripled? Let's say the v sub 2 is equal to 3 na din siya, 3v sub 1. So again, we already achieve a pattern, or we already find a pattern here from letter A. So we can say that the new velocity, or P2 na po, this is equal to mass, it will not change, and then of course the velocity 2. But since velocity 2 is equal to 3v, so that is m times 3v. Rearranging, that is 3 times m times v. And of course, we already know this. M times v is just 20,000. That is 3 times 20,000. So, diba, na-prove na itong atong pattern niya. If the velocity would increase, or if the velocity will triple, the same thing with the momentum. So, here, 60,000, this is 3 times the initial momentum. So again, if ang velocity guy kay mo quadruple pa na, or mo 6 times, mo 7 times, the same thing with the momentum, mo 7 times pud siya. So mana yung relationship between momentum and the velocity? They are directly proportional. For C, it states here that how about if its mass was doubled? So by adding more passengers and a greater load. So what if si mass na pud ang ma-change? So here, we have mass new is just equal to twice the previous mass, diba, 2m. So again, we have the previous momentum, diba? P is just equal to 20,000, which is this is equal to mass times the velocity. And the new velocity, I mean the new momentum, is just equal to the new mass, diba? For situation letter C, gibago ang mass, kaya nagdagdag mo ng mga passengers. And then, of course, the same ragi hapon niya velocity. And then, since the new mass is just twice the previous mass, so that is 2mv. And we all know this mv, diba? From the previous here, mv is just 20,000. So that will be 2 times 20,000. So that would be equal to 40,000 units. So, we can have here, makaingunta, we can conclude that if the mass is doubled, the momentum is also doubled because they are directly proportional. And the last one for letter D, how about if both its velocity was doubled and also its mass? So here we can say that another mass, let's say mass 2, is equal to twice of the previous mass, and the same thing, the velocity is also twice the previous velocity. And of course, we all know that the previous momentum is just 20,000, which is equal to the product of mass times velocity. And of course, the new momentum is just the product of the new mass and then the new velocity. And we all know that the new mass is twice the previous mass. So 2m, then the new velocity is also twice the previous velocity. So 2 times 2 is 4 times mass times velocity. And we only know this mass times velocity. That is just equal to 20,000. So that would be 4 times 20,000. That would make it 80,000. Therefore, our new momentum is equal to 80,000. And by comparing it with the previous, that is 4 times. So again, of course, that is 4 times because our mass is doubled and also our velocity. And since they are products, so 2 times 2 is equals to 4. So therefore, we increase our momentum by 4 times. So do you have a question so far? Any question, class? Okay, so wala. So let's proceed. We now here for the conservation of momentum. So for all collisions, class, a momentum ma-conserve siya for, I mean, not all the for ideal na collision. So naman tayo mga types of collision. Ideally, class, ang momentum will be conserved. So the law of conservation of momentum, so wait lang, nag-join. So the law of conservation of momentum states that for an object or for a collision, okay, mostly collision man siya or interaction between two objects. So for a collision or interaction sa duha ka object, for a collision or interaction of two or more objects, the conservation of momentum states that the momentum, the initial momentum, I mean, ato ni PDI kay kung ano ni standard ni sa pag denote sa momentum. So the initial momentum is just equal to the final momentum. So muna ma-conserve siya. Let's say nagbangga ang usa ka object. Ang usa ka object M. Nagbangga siya sa kaning object N. So naa sila yung mga velocities. Of course, kani siya, let's say the velocity of M is greater than the velocity sa kaning object N. Of course, after the collision, maybe ang usa kay mo bounce back si M. And then si N, of course, mo bounce back pod. And then, of course, let's say si N kay gaan. So, after collision, si N na pod kay medako na pod yung velocity. So, Vn is greater than Vm now. So, ingana, by this conservation of momentum, we can predict kung saan na po yung velocity ni Vn o ni Vm. But given nga na conserve momentum, meaning let's say if VM is massive, I mean the object M is massive, so that then higher for the velocity kung mo-collide siya sa other object, let's say object N which has a smaller mass and also smaller or slower a velocity, so therefore ma-transfer to AM velocity mo nang si N malabay ug insakto, so mo bounce back siya tungod kay murag na transfer na pasa niya ang momentum gikan ni object M padong ni object N. And then conservation of momentum also accompanies with the conservation of energy. So of course, sila duha related na, but for moving objects, especially for a collision, ang conservation of momentum is appropriate. So appropriate puni in order to analyze at least their velocities and also their masses. Okay, so since we have here that initial momentum is just equal to the final momentum, then we can say that the initial mass, so we have here the initial, I mean initial mass, but actually ang mass kay di man makuan, di man siya mag change ang mass object if mag collide siguro kung makatag, but kan man mostly sa atong analysis is kanang ang mass nato is ma-conserve pod, like the law of conservation of mass. So here we have mass, and then the only one or the only quantity that will change is the velocity. So we have mass of the object, let's say the object 1. Mag-assume taha nga naay usa ka object diri, unya napay usa ka object diri kaduha, and then they have velocity, this is v1 and this is v2. Okay, they are moving towards each other and they possess unique velocities. So we have v1 and v2. So here we can say that, I mean, we can use conservation of momentum in the initial momentum of the two objects is equal to the final momentum. So pagbangga nila, di ba, magsugat man sila, they were approaching and then colliding with each other. So after the collision, so namay, this is initial, so man siya ang initial nga kuan scenario. This is the initial scenario and this is the final scenario. So for the final scenario, maybe they will collide and bounce back. Bounce back na sila. So this is 1 and this is 2. Of course, they have another velocity, v2 prime. Then this one also is v2 prime. So kato ilang mga velocity previously, di na to siya ma-equal sa second, sa ilahang final velocities, because they already interact with each other. So maybe ang velocity sa usa nabalhin sa usa, and it is dependent upon their masses because of the formula of the momentum. So magvary na ilang mga velocities, maybe ang usa kay mihinay, maybe it is kanang kuan in slow siya compared to the other object, or maybe ang usa ka object kay kanang starts from kanang slow nga state, then hingkalit nang siya speed up after the collision, so nagi higher chance nga kanang mahitabo na siya. So here, let's continue. Our initial momentum is m1 multiplied by the velocity at initial, or v1 for object 1, and then all the same thing with object 2, that is plus mass 2 and then v2. And then how about the final momentum? So the final momentum is, of course, can be derived or can be observe in the final state. So mamunin siya atong final state, nagbangga na sila, or after pagbangga. So the final state is, again, we still have m1, so it will not change. Then of course we only now have v1 prime plus m2 and then v2 prime. So here they already have their new velocities after the collision. So yan ilang class. So the more objects that you're going to interact, so you can just or we can just have a general formula, let's say summation of mass and the velocity initial is just equal also to the summation of mass and the velocity of final. So ayan lang class, basically ingana lang ang conservation of momentum, but the challenge there is on sana nyo pag analyze ang problem, whether asa ang initial nga state, asa po ang mga final nga mga states. Okay, so let's proceed to the types of collision. So we have three types. The first one is elastic collision. When we say elastic collision, this is an ideal condition for your momentum. So ideal. Why? This is because in elastic collision, the kinetic energy is conserved. So, unsay pasabot, sir, sa kinetic energy kay na conserve siya? So, na conserve na to ang kinetic kanang kon energy, meaning na siya transfer sa velocities from one object to another. So, for an elastic collision class, na adre may tabo ang naay kanang mo bounce back. So, for an elastic collision class na may naampoy perfect na, I mean, our perfect magiging siyang elastic collision. So, for an elastic collision, let's say we have an object 1, of course, moving towards the right and possessing a velocity v1, and then of course we also have another object 2 possessing velocity of v2. So wait lang, then nag-join. So ang object 2 pud nagpossess siya og velocity v2. Okay. And then this is the condition before collision. So this is before or the initial condition. And then after that, for an elastic collision class, since kinetic energy is conserved, so therefore naaray transfer sa velocities. So walay na ibanan. So meaning ang velocity ni 1, if this is at higher velocity, then kaning v2 kay lower velocities. So meaning siguro mahina si velocity 1, but ang iyang kinetic energy, which is in terms of velocity, matransfer ni v2. Then si v2 pod increase siya tungod kay nahatagan siya ni v1. So yan na ba, na interaction ba and ma-conserve, meaning ang quandary wala siya lost sa energy, meaning ang energy pod nga na-possess diri, ang kinetic energy pod niya na-transfer pod niya sa kinetic energy sa ikaduha, or na-i-part nga ma-transfer niya, and then of course na-pimhabilin niya. So we can say that the change in kinetic energy of one is also equal to the change in kinetic energy of the other. So this is the final condition. So indicate sila, of course they collide with each other, but since this is an elastic collision, so anyo tigaman sa elastic collision na ay bounce back mahitabo. So mo bounce back sila. So si v1, ayan velocity now for the final is v1 prime. We just denote that one as v1 prime, and then for object 2 that is v2 prime. So yung ana. And then for an elastic collision, of course we can apply the conservation of momentum. So the same thing sa previous, you can just say that the momentum before is equal to momentum after, or the final na lang. So, wala siya. Momentum before equals momentum after. So the momentum before collision is just the product of the object 1 and its velocity 1 plus of course the object 2 na po na siya initial momentum, that is m2, and then v2, that is equal to of course the final momentum. Still we have mass 1 and then v1 prime, plus mass 2 and then v2 prime. So yun nga siya, mara siya elastic collision. Again, kinetic energy here is conserved. This is an ideal ideal nga collision. And then yung kanon nga dili magdikit, mo bounce back ang duha ka objects nga nagcollide. So mara na niya tigaman sa elastic collision. So the next one is we have completely inelastic collision. So for an inelastic collision class, it is very opposite to the elastic collision, because for completely inelastic, meaning kinetic energy is not conserved. Okay, kinetic energy is that not, I mean, is not conserved. So meaning, masayang pasabot ani class, meaning naay losses ani sa energy. And then of course this is the actual condition. Of course mo ani hitabo sa actual, this is the actual condition. Kay of course lamgi ni mga losses sa energy sa atong surroundings, mo gay na mo init. So kung mag-collide, of course, manginit po na ang mga objects. So, mo na siyang actual condition ang completely inelastic. And for completely inelastic class, it is very different from elastic kaysa elastic, di ba? Na I bounce back. Sa completely inelastic class, mo stick sila. So after collision, one object would stick to the other. So nai, so mo stick to each other. So meaning magdunga na ni sila. After collision, ang usa mo kuyog sa usa, or it's either ang katong paspas mo dagan, mupilit pud sa katong hinay mi dagan. So yan na siya. And then let's say kwan. Suppose we have again object 1 moving at higher speed, velocity 1. And then si object 2 pod moving at higher speed, V2. This is the condition before collision. But for a completely inelastic class, so me, by definition, so kung gisuwat ari, they will stick to each other. So meaning, after collision, magkuyugay na ni sila. So again, we still have mass 1 and mass 2. But the question is, if they stick together class, unsay pasabot ani? Unsa may pasabot sa ilahang velocity after the collision? This is after collision. So unsa man class? Nawa idea? Is it correct nga magbutang gihapon ko og kuan? Magbutang gihapon ko og velocity V1 prime and then V2 prime? Sakto ba or dili? Given nga mag-usa man sila, given nga mag-stick sila together, so pasabot niya na. So since mag-stick man sila, since they will stick together, so therefore dili na ta magsuwat og V1 prime and V2 prime because they already have a uniform velocity after. So kani silang duha, usa na ni sila. Usa na ni sila velocity. So therefore we can just put here V prime. Okay. So by conservation of energy, so we have here momentum before is of course equal to the momentum after collision. So momentum before collision, that is mass 1 velocity 1 plus mass 2 velocity 2 is just equal to, since ang duha ka masses kay nagcombine naman, then they have single velocity or usa sa velocity, so that would be mass 1 plus mass 2 multiplied by V prime. So this is now the formula for the conservation of energy for a completely inelastic na collision. So again, for a completely inelastic collision, kinetic energy is not conserved, and then this is also the actual condition. So therefore natay mga energy losses. And then of course, in analyzing this collision, just take note that after collision, the two objects will stick together. So meaning that their final velocities are the same. So same ra ilang velocity. The next one is the inelastic collision. So if this is not a completely inelastic collision, meaning na ay may laging-laging, so nagi diferensya ani, and we can say here that yes, kinetic energy is totally not conserved. Mas worse ni siya sa completely inelastic. So kinetic energy is totally not conserved. And then of course, na heat loss or energy losses. Maybe sa friction, pagbangga nila, na friction ni occur, so maiba na. And then kuan po, naay po heat loss. So naay heat, na friction. Then of course, na po sound energy. So ma-convert na siya into other forms of energy. So meaning, ang energy unta ang na-possess nila, which is kinetic energy, dapat unta ma-transfer sa other object para mo ma-alter ang velocity pod. But since this is inelastic collision, so wala na conserve ang kinetic energy, meaning wala na transfer sa usa ka object nga nibangga ngadto sa iyang nabanggaan. So asa man ang mga energies day ani na napunta, sir? So it is kuan padong ni siya sa init, so init man pagbangga mo init, then na friction, then of course sound kay ni magbangga di ba mapaka na, sorry, it will produce sound. So the next one we have coefficient of restitution. So say pasabot ani coefficient of restitution. So for conservation of momentum, coefficient of restitution is just the ratio of the relative speed of the relative, I mean velocity pala, before and after collision. So yan gikita kung pilay kuan velocity before and then velocity after. Actually this is velocity after, so maguna ang output or ang result. So the ratio of the relative velocity after and before a collision. So in mathematical expression, that is denoted as letter E. So regular, so that is E is equals to the V relative final all over the relative velocity initial. Okay, what is the relative velocity on the final? Let's say balik taan to sa itong derive, di ba? Na-derive man ta nga for an, let's say mag-una ta sa kuan elastic collision. So for elastic collision, di ba, we all know that the by conservation of momentum, that is mass 1, say this is 1 and 2, of course they have V1 then plus mass 2 and then V2 is equal to mass 1 V2 prime, I mean V1 prime, and then plus mass 2 then V2 prime. So here, what is the relative or what are the velocities on the in the final state? So that is just V2 and V1. And since we're talking about relative velocity, so ngayon get the relative velocity, actually that is the difference. So the difference, so that would be V2 prime minus V1 prime. And then the next one is V1 minus V2, or you can have V2 minus V1, so it's up to you, as long as you take the difference, okay, since it deals about the relative velocity sa final state or sa initial state. So for an elastic collision class, since kinetic energy is conserved man, so meaning ang relative velocity dali mo sa final. So for an elastic collision class, di ba KE is conserved? Okay, so kung ma-conserve ni siyang kinetic energy, then kung unsay difference sa mga velocities before would also equal to the velocity or the difference of the velocities after. So therefore, for elastic collision class, ang E nato diri is equal to 1. Okay, wala may nasayang kinetic energy kay elastic mo ni siya. But how about for inelastic? How about for inelastic collision? So for inelastic collision class, remember that by the law of conservation of momentum, we have here mass 1 V1 plus mass 2 V2 is equal to, diba, they already now have equal velocity or same na ilang velocity, so that would be V prime. So here we have E is equals to what is the relative velocity final, so that is V prime na lang, that is V prime. So here, I mean that is not V prime. Ang relative velocity man towards each other. So meaning, let's assume na we use the general formula. Kani man ang general formula ani. So since this is general formula, so by applying for the inelastic collision, so that is v2 prime minus v1 prime, then over v1 minus v2. And since for an inelastic collision class, diba, same lang ilahang velocity at the final state, diba? Si mass 1 o si mass 2 per half velocity. So therefore, we can say that v2 prime is equal to v prime, and then the same with v1 prime, that is equal to v prime divided by v1 minus v2. So since equal man sila, this is for a perfect or completely half perfect inertia or completely inelastic. So here, that this would be 0, diba? 0 all over v1 minus v2, or just simply 0. So ang coefficient of restitution di niya is 0 for a perfect or completely inelastic collision. So for an elastic collision class, equal to 1. But if that is from 0 to 1, so mo na tong actual nga inelastic condition. So for an inelastic na dili siya complete, ang atong we still again use the formula kaning v2 prime minus v1 prime all over v1 minus v2. And then for an inelastic, since na ay mga losses, na ay mga energy losses, we can say that the range of its coefficient of restitution is from 0 to 1. So mo na siya class. Okay, of course, kita aragod, start siya 0, meaning worst case na gina siya, lagi na mga losses. Then, I mean, if mo start siya sa 0, kuhan siya, perfect ihang pagkuhan, pag collide din, like, mag-stick together sila. So, kanin sila mag-stick together. Kaya, di ba, kung 0 ang ikay, inelastic, perfect inelastic. But, between 0 and 1, so na mga losses. So, kanin siya, losses niyari. So, from 0 to 1, losses, and then, 1 here indicates that that is an elastic. So meaning mag-bounce na sila. So again, for the coefficient of restitution, for starting at 0, that is perfect inelastic. So starting from 0, that is perfect inelastic. And then midway between 0 and 1, naandra ang mga inelastic. So inelastic collision, meaning na yung mga losses due to heat, friction, and sound. And then, as it approaches to 1, marito, ang inelastic, makonvert na siya into an elastic condition, meaning that the kinetic energy is now conserved. So, nagkanama na nag-conserve. So, that would, that's why our E here, or the coefficient of restitution, is already equivalent to 1. So, na question so far? My question. Okay, so let's proceed to problems on momentum. So here we have a 12 kilogram railroad car is traveling at 2 meters per second when it strikes another 10 kilogram railroad car that is at rest. So if the cars lock together, what is the final speed of the two railroad cars? So we have here given, or we can have both given and illustration. So here, naada ko na yung usa ka railroad car, let's say muna siya. And then, this is 12,000, so bugat kayo. 12,000 kilogram, and then traveling at 2 meter per second. So let's say it travels in this direction. So that is in 2 meter per second. We can let this as A. So this is of course VA, and this is mass A. And then as it travels class, it strikes another railroad car. Let's say this is another railroad, the railroad car B. And then the mass here, MB, is equal to 10,000. Medyo gaan-gaan siya. And then at rest. So meaning unsa man ni wa naglihok. So therefore we can say that VB initially is 0, kay wala man siya naglihok. And then consider if the cars lock together da kuno. So after mi collide sila, ni lock daw, meaning this is before. So this is before, and then the scenario after collision is this one, A, and then this one is B. So meaning they stick together. So again, kung sa ganun stick together, meaning this is a completely inelastic, kaya nag-stick man siya. So therefore, they already now have a single velocity. So we can put here or mark here as V prime. And then, of course, they still have masses. So this is the condition after collision. And this is completely inelastic. Okay, inelastic ni siya. So therefore, solution required. The required here is the V prime or the velocity after or the final speed of the two velocity of the two railroad cars. So nagdikit naman sila, so their velocities are the same after the collision. So how are we going to analyze this? So again, use the conservation of momentum. So what is the conservation of momentum? That is the momentum before is equal to the momentum after collision. So what is the momentum before? So that would be mass of the railroad car A multiply its velocity plus mass of another railroad multiply its velocity is just equal to the sum of their masses and then multiplied by their final velocity since both of them stick together. So naras like usara ka velocity. And since ang ating pangita is V prime, so we can just divide both sides by MA plus MB. The same thing, this is MA plus MB. So we now have our final velocity. We have V prime is just equal to MAVA plus MBVB divided by MA plus MB. Since we know that VB is 0, so this would now be 0. Again, diba? Nag-address ba siya? So that would be 0. That will equal to 0. So what's left now is MAVA all over MA plus MB. Then substitute the given values. So mass A is 12,000. And then velocity A is 2 meter per second. So be consistent with the unit. So this is in kilogram meter per second, and then the denominator is MA plus MB, so that is 12,000 plus 10,000, and this one is in kilogram. So therefore, we have kilogram on the numerator, kilogram on the denominator, so what's left is meter per second, which is the unit for our velocity. So, after I calculate, so that would be 12,000 times 2 all over 12,000 plus 10,000. So the answer is 1.09. So that is approximately 1.09 meter per second. So mo na ilahang final velocity class nga mistake sila together. So naay question? Do you have a question? Wala. Okay, so let's proceed. The next problem, so railroad jagi hapon. We have here, so again sa previous sakay kanto siya completely inelastic, kaya nag-stick man sila together. So here, again, a 9,300 kilogram railroad car traveling at a velocity of 15 meter per second strikes a second box car at rest. If the two cars stick together and move off with a velocity of 6 meters per second, what is the mass of the second car? So here we have figure and data first, or we have given an illustration. So again, nabutay lain nga railroad car. Railroad car A, where its mass is 9,300 kg, kilogram, and travel siya at a velocity of 15 meter per second. So mga ito na siya, padong. Unya, nakabangga na po siya. So hilig niya siya bangga. Nakabangga na po siya another car. But this time, this is at rest. So therefore, we can say, at MB, since mo magipangita na, diba MB, watakaybaw. But we know its velocity, that is 0. Since this one is at rest. So this one is addressed. This is the condition before collision. What is the condition after collision? So, if the two cars stick together and move off with a velocity of 6 meters per second, therefore, the state after collision is this. So, nagkadungan sila, nag-stick man sila, and then of course, it has velocity, that is V prime, is equals to 6 meters per second. So, the question is, what is the mass of the second car? So, this is a completely inelastic, so completely inelastic collision siya, kaya nag-stick man sila. At ang ibutang nga, they stick together, so nag-stick na sila. So required, we need to find mass of the other boxcar or the boxcar or the second car. So solution, by conservation of energy, by conservation of momentum. Okay, since on motion man siya, so pwede na makuha sa conservation of momentum. So here we have momentum before, same ragyapon, is just equal to momentum after. So momentum before is mass A velocity A plus mass B velocity B is equal to, since uniform naman sila o sara sila velocity sa after, so that would be mass A plus mass B multiplied by a single velocity V prime. And then since VB is 0, so this quantity here will be 0, so what's left is mass A VA is equals to mass A plus mass B multiplied by V prime. Since si mass V ang ipangita, so we can multiply both sides by 1 over V prime to make it mass A VA over V prime is equal to mass A plus mass B. Transpose mass A on the other side in order to isolate mass B on the other. So mass B is now mass A VA all over V prime minus mass A. Then substituting the values, so the answer is what? So we have MB is just equal to, we can factor out MA actually. MA then VA over V prime minus 1. And what is MA? That is 9,300 kilogram multiplied by VA, that is 15 all over V prime, so V prime is in 6 meter per second, then minus 1. So the final answer MB is equal to 9,300 times 15 divided by 6 minus 1, that is 13,950. So exactly 13,950 kilogram. So please be consistent with your units. So naipangata na? So far. Okay na, sabtan na. So let's proceed for problem number 3. So here, it states that a 57 kilogram basketball player jumps vertically upward to make a shot. At the very top of her jump, so babae din siya, she throws the baseball with a speed of 4.4 meter per second. What is her recoil velocity immediately after she releases the ball? The mass of the basketball is 0.62 kilogram. Class, when we say recoil class, kaning gitawag nga recoil velocity, ma-apply po nila to sa kanang sa mga pusil. Recoil velocity mo siya ang reacting ni siya nga velocity. So mo-counteract siya. 'Di ba ang pusil ng imo na pusil, 'di ba mura po nag ilabay imong kamot, so kung wa kay kusog maigo imong naong, so kay tungod sa impact ba kusog ba na ang bullet, kusog kay ma-accelerate mo nang mo recoil siya na siya reaction, so ma-reacting velocity na niya, so may pasabot niya. And then here ato na kun is of course the figure and of course its corresponding data. or the given and illustration. So figure and data, we assume this is the ground level, so naadi rin babae, and then he jumps siya upward, so she is 57 kilogram, jumps siya upward pagabot niya ni, so of course naramay maximum height nga makaambak ka. Pag jump niya upward, tira siya sa aning bola, tira siya sa bola, and then siguro na naadiray ko an basketball court. Ay basketball court. Pag tira niya class, ang basketball kay hing travel at the speed of padong saring na siya. That is 4.4 meter per second. The question is, what is her recoil velocity immediately after she releases the ball? So the mass of the basketball is 0.62 kilogram. So here we have mass of the ball is equal to 0.62 kilogram. And then the mass of the girl, mg na lang, is 57 kilogram. Okay, here, pag problema ni class, pag-analyze, sir, asa man ang before collision at after collision? Actually, kanya siya, wala ni nag-collide. And then, dili ingon nga, if wala ni nag-collide, we cannot analyze this one using momentum. Of course, di ba, ang momentum kay not only limited for collision, it is also, can be applied on kuan on kanang objects interacting with each other, then nagtransfer sa mga velocity. So here unsa may nag-interact nato, duha ka entity ang nag-interact. We have the ball, the basketball, and the girl. So since ang girl kay nasa mas, we can say nga before pa niya pag-throw, ha, ang before ani is kanang before throwing the ball. So mo ni ang initial condition before throwing the ball. Okay, here unsa man ato makuan ani, unsa mga datas nga ato makita ani. So before throwing the ball, of course tuwa pa siya sa max height, siya sa iyang kaugalingon wa siya naglihok kay maximum height na biya ni, di ba? This is now max height. Again, review sa atong free fall o projectile. Kung na sa babaw, free fall gali, mo jump ka, your velocity at max height is 0, di ba? So therefore, we can say nga, let's say, velocity then ni girl before is equal to 0. Of course, napoy mas si girl nga 57 kilogram. How about for basketball? I mean the ball. We can denote this as VB. Since si ball kay gigunita ni girl, which is same sila kay hin travel sa at max height, since si ball kay gunita pa ni girl, so meaning both of them has zero velocity initially. So zero gihapon si ball, then of course na yung massive ball nga equal to 0.62 kilogram. Then the next one, sir, asa man ani ang after? So after the interaction na siya ang kuana na is of course after throwing. So after throwing the ball, so paglabay niya sa bola, nanapod tay velocity sa girl kay di ba namay tay recoil. So again, recoil is the reacting velocity, so we don't know this. And then of course same ra gyapon niyang mass, 57 kilogram. And then how about for the velocity prime of the ball? So gingan man dire ang ball dako na kay gibad tak niya 4.4 meter per second. So that is 4.4 meter per second. And then again nagamatay masa ball equal to 0.62 kilogram. Okay, requirements here, the required is the velocity of the girl or the recoil velocity, monay reacting velocity sa girl. So again, conservation of momentum, that is momentum before is just equal to momentum after. Okay, the momentum before collision is, this is mg, mass sa girl, velocity sa girl, plus mass sa ball. Velocity sa ball is just equal to mass sa girl, loses a girl at the final state plus mass a boy v primes a boy. Since vg and vb, the velocities of the girl and the boy at initial is zero, so zero is lutaran na rin. So what's left now is this one. So here we can transpose mass a girl, I mean mass a boy, not boy, mass a ball. Okay, here that is mgvg prime is equal to negative mb and then vb prime. Divide both sides by mg. So we now have vg prime is equal to negative mb vb prime all over mg. So substitute, that is negative. Ang mb na to class is 0.62. That is 0.62 kilogram. Vb prime is 4.4. Divided by mg is 57. So approximately equal to 0.62 times 4.4 divided by 57. That is 0.08. That is 0.08 meters or meter per second. So of course, nearly magnesia like gamay ra kani siyang reacting velocity. Mao na murag tendency nga murag malabay kay babay mura ba makaingon siya banga marshag na na kwan ba marshag king working feet away nga na kay mao na ang iya recoil velocity since nintro man siya og speed padong sa bola, so mana iya ang recoil velocity or the reacting velocity. Any question? I mean, this is not 0.08 day, 0.0478. 0.0478 din siya. 0.0478. So, gamay kayo. So, na-question so far? Wala na? Okay. Actually, common na siya ang mga problems. Nagin na siya kaning mga recoil velocity. Not only sa kaning situation, but also in kana analyzing sa mga bullets kanang ato mga guns naman ay bullet, so i-like-on ko unsa recoil velocity. Kung dako ganig recoil velocity, lisod na kay na i-handle na nga mga rifles, dapat gamay ra velocity mga rifles. Okay, the next one is impulse. Oh, impulse and momentum, they are related to each other, but when we interpret, they mean different thing. So, nasile differences. So, impulse, this is a quantity that counteracts momentum. So, actually, when we have momentum class, na po impulse may tabo. Because we change velocity, therefore, ang ma-change po dato impulse. So, unsa rin ang impulse? Ganang kung ma-change ang velocity, ma-change ang momentum, ma-change po ang impulse. Actually, by definition class, impulse, we can denote that one as capital I is equal to the product now of force and time. So that is force and time or delta T. And impulse is a vector quantity. Again, why? Because of this quantity F. Force is a vector quantity, so therefore the impulse is a vector quantity. And the same thing with momentum, impulse can be used to analyze collision. So the main example of this one is when you are in a trampoline. When you are in a trampoline, so diba sa trampoline, dili sakit kung mag-ambak-ambak ka, dili ma-sprain ang imong muscles because sinaitabo ani. Tungod aning kaning kuan, kaning murag kaning fabric, tungod sa fabric, iyan na absorb ang imong momentum. So, iyan na-absorb due to the fabric. Elastic man ang fabric, so iyan pahinahinayan imuhang pagkuan, paglukso-lukso para di ka masakitan. Kaya unlike if you are kanang jumping on a concrete, let's say sa kalsada ka, ambak-ambak ka, di ba? Sakit sa kuan, sakit sa tail kadugayan because ang concrete very sturdy, gamay iya pag-absorb. So, in order to visualize that, pwede na nato ma-analyze by using impulse and momentum. But for now, we'll just talk about impulse. Ang impulse class is this one. Let's say kaning sakyanan, wa siya choice, siguro nakamit niya siyang accident sa road, so hing-choose na lang siya nga mo das mag siya aning haystack. So maning haystack kanang sa kwan ba kaning sa humay ni siya kanang nigani gali niya ilang ikuan email, so mani mauhot haystack. So here na siya energy mo nang kabante mo, this is MV, so this is momentum. Of course massive maning car, it has mass and velocity, kusog kayo. Of course, kung imo na siya ipabanggag concrete class, so ang imo sakyanan pabanggaan imo kuan concrete, say metabo, what happens? Diba? Katag tungod kay ang concrete kay wala murabag ka ng sturdy siya, so impact gid niya, bungkag. Whereas kung haystack class, diba kay lightweight materials man siya, tungod kay uhot man eh. So, naapay time, diba kay kung muhit ka, diba, if we collide, of course, we have force. Diba? We exert force. So, sa concrete, ang i-exert force, mapunay, kung sa i-exert nga force, mapunay i-exert sa wall. So, kung dako kay ang force na ito, kipas-pas ka mudagan, mapunay i-exert sa wall mo nang bungkag yun sa kinan. Whereas, kung haystack, ang composition sa haystack is, makakam niya siya, kanang porous, niya, soft, humok. So, therefore, iya pa i-absorb. I-absorb niya ang momentum. Diba kay two objects ba ni? We have object 1 car, object 2 kay haystack. So, object 2 i-absorb tarang kinetic energy ani nga car. So, mao nang ang car mo slows down unya di siya ma-damage. And then katong time class nga nagbangga ay sila, diba kay iya man gi-absorb, so meaning midikit sila hantod nga nakatag na buwag. So, katong time mo siya gi-indicate ani class kaning delta T. Muna ang impulse. Ang impulse muna siya nagpabag-o sa ato momentum. Nganong nagpabag-o man sir? It's because ang momentum nato, 'di ba? Ang momentum sa car is fixed kaning MV. Pag bangga na niya, tol kay mipugong ni si haystack, na interaction nilang duha. Meaning ang kinetic energy sa car kay nabalhin pud sa ni haystack or na-absorb niya. Or iyang na pabago. Maunang, mo slow down ang sakyanan. And also, accompanied by the, kuan, the brakes po, ang mga brakes. So, meaning, siya'y nagpabago. So, manang impulse causes the change of momentum. And the same thing, momentum also causes the change of impulse. So, vice versa. Mugayin, related na ng impulse at momentum. And then, of course, if we collide, of course, we have force. So, kanin si car na nag-exert yun siya force na haystack. So, natay force, unya ang kadugay yun nga nag-interact ang duha pag-collide. Meaning, ang product ni ana nga ang force gi-exert sa car, unya ang interaction nilang duha, ang time nga nag-interact sila or nagdikit is equal to the impulse. So, unit analysis, force is in what? This is in kilogram meter per second square, or mass times acceleration due to gravity times the second, or we can rewrite this in Newton then second. So basically mo na siya ang atong impulse. But impulse class and momentum, they are both equal. Why? Because if we're going to simplify this, kaning Newton second mahimo kaning kilogram meter, diba, second squared multiplied by second, what happened? Dire mas second lang. So therefore this is kilogram meter per second. And diba, do you know that this is the same with the momentum? Diba ang momentum is kilogram meter per second because it is the product of mass and velocity, wherein this is mass in kilogram, the velocity is this meter per second. So see, both quantities are the same, ang impulse ang momentum. But momentum deals with the mass of the object and its velocity, while impulse concerns with the force exerted by the object towards the other object, and also the time nga nag-interact silang duha, nagdikit ba sila pag collide nila. And then these two here, actually by the second law of Newton, we can say that the force is just the change in momentum, that is delta P, all over delta t. That's why if we're going to cross multiply this, it will just result to delta p equals to f delta t. So mana siya class. So basically mo nang impulse, it is a quantity that counteracts momentum, product of force and the time, and then a vector quantity and with momentum, both of them are used to analyze collision in mga scenarios. So impulse and momentum, I think I already discussed to you kanina lang sa motosiya. It has, let's say this one car, then in collide siya sa other objects, let's say an unknown object. So of course it possesses greater momentum. Let's say in this point nag-travel niya at this speed. Of course the car has mass 1. And then pag-abot niya diri, syempre may brake ni siya. May brake ni siya insakto. Tungod kay kita siya aning kuan kanang boulder niya. May na lang kay din siya concrete. So meaning gi-absorb gamay, marang hing warp ni siya. So the time nga ni gi-absorb niya, so natay gitawag nga delta t. Of course, bidikit man siya ni class, it exerts force, di ba? F. So and then of course, ang velocity one, let's say constant man siya. So i-move siya ari class, pag abot niya diri nga point, still it has v1 gihapon nga speed, assuming nga wala nag-change ang iyahang kuan. Assuming that its velocity does not change, uniform niya, wala acceleration. Pag abot niya diri sa point class, hing touch na gid siya ani nga object, di ba? Hing warp. I-absorb sa object yung kinetic energy. Ana. So, kaninga point nga, pag-absorb na class, di ba, muhunong. Of course, muhunong, binaang sakinan. So, naa kay itawag nga V2. So, therefore, what we can do here is, di ba, the change in momentum is equal to the change in impulse ra. Di ba? Muna ang relationship sa impulse and momentum. Both of them are equal when we are dealing with analysis on objects that are interacting with each other, especially in motion or in a certain collision nga situation or event. So here on sama ng change in momentum class, of course follow ka lang. Momentum final minus momentum initial, which is what is the change in impulse, again that is the force since naman siya lagi exert ng force, times the change in temperature f delta d. Masa may momentum final. The final momentum is just the mass of this car, mass 1, then V2, minus the initial is mass 1, then V1. That's equals to F delta T. Basically, money interaction or kana equation nga interact sa impulse and momentum. Okay, so let's proceed to some problems regarding with this. So we have the first problem. So it states here that a 1.3 kilogram ball is coming straight at a 75 kilogram soccer player at 13 meter per second who kicks it in the exact opposite direction at 22 meter per second with an average force of 12 newton. So how long are his foot and the ball in contact? Okay. So we have here figure and data. Mingan daw a 1.3 kilogram ball, so mo ni ang bola, so ang mass sa ball is 1.3 kilogram, and then let's say tiil ni siya sa soccer player, so tiil ni siya kay gipatiran man ning bola unya ngadto ang bola padong iya direction, ngadto ang direction sa left 13 meter per second. Pero counteract na siya, 'di ba? Nag-collide ang bola ug ang tiil sa soccer player. Kaning tiil, of course, mibangga man siya ning bola, nagin na sila forces. Of course, ang force nga gi-interact sa bola equal pud sa force sa tiil sa soccer player, because 'di ba by third law of Newton, law of interaction, so equal na siya action and reaction forces. So therefore ang kaning tiil na exert na siya og force, that is F. And then what is this F? Nara, with an average force da of 1200 newton, so we can say that F is equals to 1200 newton. So managi interact nila duha. And then how long are his foot and the ball is in contact? So diba pag iguan nila, nagani nanay second nga nag-contact na sila before pag-release sa kuan. So natay delta t ara. And then pag kuan na, pag igo na pod, di ba nag hinkuan siya, hindi kit silang duha. Kay pag collide na duha, hindi kit unya gipatiran man. May exert man silang duha og 120 newton. So therefore nalabay na pagbalik ang bola. Kay di ba kung patiran yung bola, malabay balik niya. Unsa may ihang ikaduha nga kuan after collision na. So after collision mo ni siya. Nalabay na siya, ngato na siya. Ngato na siya. Nya iyang velocity now is 22 meter per second. Again, same as 1.3 kilogram. Okay. So kaning soccer player is 75 kilogram siya. So 75 kg. Okay. So required is how long are his foot and the ball in contact, so that would be delta t. Okay, solution. Again, since this is an impulse and momentum interaction, so we can say that the impulse, the change in impulse is equal to the change in momentum. What is the change in impulse? This is just the force times the change in time, delta t, which is equal to the change in momentum, that is the momentum before collision. Again, we are focusing on the ball. Si ball, kasi ball raman ani mo ay ni-interact. Assuming nga kaning kay nagkana ni. Assuming nga kana external ni siyang kuan kaning soccer nga soccer player, kaning tail soccer player. So, we are focusing on the ball kay si ball mong good pod ang nagkana ni. Ang nagliho kayo. Okay. So, for the ball, massa ball, then velocity niya final is kaning 22. So we considered nga ang velocity towards the right is positive, so that is 22. And then minus the initial, what is the initial? 13. And since 13 is towards the left, so that is negative. So that is negative 13. Close parenthesis, and that's it. Since we have F, so we can just divide both sides by F para si T na lang mahibilin. So we have delta T is equals to the mass of the ball is 1.3, so that is 1.3 kg. Then this is 22 plus 13, that is in meter per second, divided by the force is 1000, then kilogram meter per second squared. So kani siya makancel ang kilogram, makancel ang mass niya, kani usan lang ka s makancel ni. So therefore correct ato ang unit. So isolve na nimo, that is 1.3 times 22 plus 13 divided by 1200. The resulting answer is approximately 0.038. So approximately 0.038 seconds. So mauni ang time nga nagdikit ang tiil sa soccer player gang kanang kuan ang bola. Okay class. Next question. Okay ra. Okay. So let's proceed to the next one. So, in problem 2, it states here that a 60 kilogram woman jumps from a burning building and falls 10 meters before making contact with a safety net. So, which stops her in 0.120 seconds? So, what is the average force exerted by the net on her? Okay, so, ang kanisiya, first tubahaton is again, figure and data. So figure and data. So here, yung jump daw kuno sa nagpakamatay o di day, kinamday net. So maragiluwas ni siya sa naari building. So tiri siya gikan. Kunya, ang iyang mass, so that is mass of the woman is 60 kilogram. Okay. Yung jump ra siya, again class, unsa ragud to kung ambak ra ka? This is free fall. So what is the initial velocity of the woman? That is v1 is equal to 0 meter per second. Kay mi-jump raman siya. Ang height sa building is 10 meters. So this is 10 meters. Padong ubos sa ubos na net. So class at this point, di ba na pani velocity ko sukod ni velocity class. At na i-denote that v v2. So pag kahit pa lang nila niya sa net class, kusog na kay velocity. Mo nang kung y net class, di ba? Kung concrete ra, mapisrat gid mo nang wa patay gid. Labi na kay 10 meters, so patay. Mo nang na net kay ang net class siya mo pa hinay sa velocity mo nang natay impulse ari. So pag kanet na class, hing stretch ang net. Actually exaggerate na ha. Mi-stretch ang net para iyang pugngan ang impact sa woman. Munang na ay point diri nga pagana niya diri. Kaninga part diri class wa na hinghulong na ang woman tungod kay iyang giabsorb tanan ang impact sa woman. So natay V3. Okay, analysis. V2 can be solved using free fall. Oh, munang gamit na pud to atong mga topic sa una kay di ba? Hing fall man siya at a height. So gamit na po tong free fall na to. And then for V3 now is 0y. Ito yung pagkatagak sa woman, of course, ang goal sa net kay masaw siya nga di siya ma-discrush siya niya. Muhunong po siya, of course. So V3 now is equal to 0. So ang atong pag-analyze ani class is during raman sa collision kani or interaction. So dire rata, wala na ilabot ng pagkatagak niya. So dala lang. So we can say nga this is our initial, or this is before, and then this one is after. So what else? Naay time. So ang time diri delta t kay hing stop man siya na, which stops her. So that is 0.120 second. Then what is the average force exerted by the net? So tungod kay hunong siya nagi-exert ang net niya muna siya, that is force F. Wata kay ba ani? So therefore ang required diri is the force, so unknown. Okay, solution. So solution, again the change in impulse is just equal to the change in momentum tungod kay insert matang force ali nga in motion po ng object. So therefore na interaction gid sa duha. So change in impulse is just the force times delta t is equal to the change in momentum is just the mass of the woman multiplied by the velocity after. So sa may velocity after, that is v3, minus velocity before. So velocity before is v2, but v2 is a downward man, di ba? Kay paubos gud. So ang v2 kaning v2 negative na siya. So minus negative v2. But we don't know v2 yet. So by in free fall, so in free fall, in order to get the final velocity, we're going to use the third kinematic equation. So I hope you can remember wherein you have the final velocity. So we assume here that the final velocity is v2 squared is equal to the initial, that is v1 paghatak sa babay squared minus 2g delta y. And we know that delta y is 10 meters ang height na sa building, so this would now be 0 kay give free fall man. That is v2 is equal to the square root of negative 2g delta y. Don't worry with the negative because ang y put kay negative ganon pa downward ba yan ng 10 meters. So that is negative 2 times 9.81 times 10. So what would be the answer? Approximately 2 times 9.81 times 10. That is 14. So 14, that is 14 meters per second approximately. That is V. Then substitute niya dito sa to equation. So we now have F delta T is equal to MW V3 plus V2 na siya. Divide both sides by delta T. So what's left is the force. Mo na siya tong gipangita. So the mass of the woman is 60 kilogram. That is 60 kilogram. V3 is 0 meters per second. V2 is 14. So this is 14 meter per second. Divide by time is 0. This one ato sa erase ha. The time is 0.120 seconds. So ma-cancel ang sec, I mean ma second square na ni 3. So you now have 60 times 14 divided by 0.12. That is 700. So F here is 700 newtons. I mean 7000 newtons. So mao na ang force nga gi-exert sa net para lang mahunong ang babae pagkatagak. Nya di siya makan. Wala di siya siya may tabo. Di siya ma-injured. Okay, so any question so far? Question class. Okay ra? Okay, so let's proceed. So the third problem is this one. A car is stopped for a traffic light. So when the light turns green, the car accelerates, increasing its speed from 0 to 5.2 meter per second in 0.832 seconds. What are the magnitudes of the linear impulse and the average force experienced by a 70 kilogram passenger in the car during this time? So can you see, again, figure and data. So figure and data. So ang car do ko no nagwathuwat ni kay nagstop man. Nagwat na ni nga mo signal ang traffic light. So pagka green na, di ba ready na? Nya moto padaga na siya. So gikan pag stop niya, di ba? That is, let's say this is car, so we have V1 equals to 0, kaya nag-stop ba yan? Nagkalit na siya bulhot. Ano? Nya, ning V2 din siya equals 5.2 meter per second. O, diba? Kani pagkabulot niya, diba maka-experience ka? If you're going to kuan, to put pressure, greater pressure sa imo accelerator pad, diba, marakag malabay sa kuan, malabay ka pa backwards. Muna yung na-experience na kay murag reaction nga kan, reactive force or katong reactive velocity. The same thing with this. So natay impulse pa dani. Tungod kay change man ato ang velocity, which is accompanied sa atong momentum. So we also have here time. Time is 0.832 seconds. So ang naitabo ni siya is at 0.82 seconds. So kung ato nga tukuan, ato na i-zoom out to sud, ato na yung siya. So naitaw ari. So diba, ang tao kay kuan man, sakay man siya. So pag move ani 5 cm per second, kanin siya, kanin iyan chair, kay mo exert siya force kay siya by the first law, katong law of kuan, law of inertia, na tendency kit, naay tendency ta nga muratag mahabilin kung magsakay tag sakinan niya mo accelerate siya, na naay tendency nga mahabilin ta mo nang ang atong labay padong ngadto. So man ang sauon ta aning seat mo na ingon siya nga, what are the magnitudes of the linear impulse and the average force experienced by a 70 kilogram passenger in the car during this time? So mo niya pag ana niya muratag malabay pa kuan pabalik, pero kay na may seat, so i-exert ang force. So kana naaray time nga nagdikit ka ikaw ang seat na ay time ani mo ng delta t. So mo nang gamit ang impulse ari. So again, naghunong ka nya, may accelerate ka og 5.2, then nakay na ay exert ang force nimo ang seat og ikaw pod. Both of them are equal but opposite direction lang. Then you have delta t, which is 0.832. So we are good to go. Kay ang atubod ani is ikaw man ang subject ani, di man ang car. So ang mass nimo, ang mass sa person MP is equal to 70 kilogram. So kay ikaw man og ang chair. So kani siya chair. Inside the car, chair og ang human, let's say the human or the driver or the passenger. I mean passenger di ay dira. So human passenger. Ang human passenger og ang chair sa car mao ay nag-interact. So indikit sila, di ba? Kay madikit wi na bug pagana malabay ka pa luyo, nagdikit mo. So ang katong time nga nagdikit mo, mao to ang kuan time nga nasa impulse. Okay. So unsay dipangita? Required. So the required here is linear impulse or I. So what takay ba linear impulse and then the F. Okay, solution. So since gipaitan linear impulse, so we all know that the change in the linear impulse is just equal to the change in momentum. So delta P. So we can say that I pala here is delta P. That is mass sa human, MP, or the person, multiplied by the final velocity, that is V2. And the final velocity is towards the right, so no worry, positive na siya. Minus V1, so minus V1. MP is 70 kilogram times V2 is 5.2 minus V1 of 0. So our momentum pala, I mean impulse, is 70 times 5.2. That is 364. That is 364. Actually, you can use Newton second or kilogram meter second. But for impulse, Newton second magigamit. So this is the first answer. The second one is the force. So we all know that impulse is just force times delta T. So if we're going to divide both sides by delta T, we can now achieve force. So force is impulse divided by delta T. And we already know impulse. Impulse is 364 Newton second divided by 0.832 seconds. So cancel ang second. Now we now have Newton lang. So Newton is 364 by 0.832. That is 437.15. So that is the force nga na experience nimo nga mura ka gihabilin o mura ka nabilin or mura ka nalabay pabalik. So mura imong na felt nimo. Manang hinihina gid pa accelerate. Manang uban nga kusog rin pag-accelerate mo malabay gid ka or mahatak gid kay nga na ba labi na kung nakamotor ka. So naipangutan na. Okay, so proceed ta. We now in angular momentum. So ang kaning angular momentum class, this applies for rotating body. So rotating body, kay di ba ang sa linear momentum class kay kanto siya rectilinear man siya or it travels in a straight line. Muna siya sa linear momentum. But how about kung mag-analyze tag mga kaan, mga collision sa body nga hing follow sila og kanang circular path. So for circular path day class nga motion ang atong gamitan kay angular momentum. So unsay mathematical nga expression ang angular momentum. So angular momentum is just the product of the linear momentum times or and so product of the linear momentum and the arm or the moment arm. So let's say natay axis of rotation then natay object array. Can you see ya? Of course natay linear momentum. So unsay linear momentum niya? Kaning velocity niya diri. That is of course it has mass. So mass times the velocity. Of course nata aning kaan the radius of the arm. So let's say this is R. Mao na siya ang radius of rotation. Magtuyok man siya. So by definition class We can just denote angular momentum as h. So na uban h or ato h lang. So angular momentum h is just equal to the product of linear momentum. So linear momentum is p multiplied by r. We all know nga ang linear momentum is just the mass of this object and then the linear velocity v. So that is mvr. And since we all know that the linear velocity, diba? We know that the linear velocity v is just equal to what? The radius times the angular velocity, diba? Nampo ni angular velocity kinatuyo gani. So substitute that one to our equation, that is equal to mrwr or mr squared w. But I think po pala takabot ani nga kuan nga topic kaning mr squared. Actually this mr squared class is just the moment of inertia, so I hope na may advance nga pagbasa ani sa module 1. Mr squared is the moment of inertia, the mass moment of inertia. So we can say that this one is I is for mass moment of inertia, yeah, W. Okay, so I kakaroon ni din siya impulse. This is mass moment of inertia. Okay, so by looking at this class, dako ang momentum sa usaka, I mean, dako iya angular momentum class kung dako iyang mass moment of inertia. Kung paspas po siya matuyok, dako po yung moment of inertia. That's why class, bantay mo, kung dako na yung mohang gipatuyok ng flywheel, di ba natin flywheel sa itong mga pan engines, dako na siya class, dako kaya hang I. So H is equal to IW. So kung dako yung mohang moment of inertia, dako kayo no, ay flywheel kay mas massive na kayo niya, ang r niya kay increase po, di ba? Then mass. So dako kay kag angular momentum ani. Especially kung paspas niya motuyok, dako kag angular momentum. And then angular momentum class is kanang iyan na siyang kuan, yang capability sa so, object nga kanang kuan lisod kay siya pugngan. So very difficult to stop if you have higher angular momentum kay limang kanyo nagtuyok na ni niya. Bugat kayo niya. Dako pa jud kayo. So mo nang ang flywheel gamit kina siya sa engine kay dako ka siya angular momentum. So dako iya ang ihang kanang higher kaya ha probability nga mukan maka-store siya higher energy. Okay, mo lang igamit para mo store energy gikan sa kuan, gikan sa pagtuyok sa mga pistons niya na. So mo nang gamit sa mga flywheel. And then not only that, gamit po din sa ubang mga cases. And I hope naka-familiar mo sa rocket, yung mga capsules na gisend sa space. Kaya nga no, sa space ba? Kaya let's say, mga Earth, na yung gawas ng rocket sa space. So, in the outer space, vacuum, walay air. So, meaning, lisod pag pa, kuan, lisod pag pahinay sa mga kuan, sa spacecraft. So, what they did, especially ka ng uban nga mga kuan, mga spaceship nga magtuyok galit. So ilang buhaton para mahunong pag spin kay pag launch ana sa rocket, tuyok man na iban mo tuyok. So pag launch ana, nagtuyok na. So unsaon man nila paghunog tuyok kay dito wala may air, vacuum na siya. Nagigamit kay gi-apply ni sila ng principle sa angular momentum. What they did is simply kaning rocket nagtuyok ni siya aning axis, di ba? Ni spin ni siya at this axis. So what did you notice class? Of course na siya diameter or na po siya radius, and then of course na siya mass. So what happens, yung angular momentum karon is equal to I W wala siya, and then I is m r square w. So unsay ang gibuhat para, di ba, ang w ani kusog pa kayo, ayang goal naman good kay muhina rin is w. So unsay ang buhaton para muhina yung pagspin, para of course syempre basig malipong po daw sa kay dere eh. mas may muhuno ang pag-spin. So what they did is nagpalabay sila, gi-stretch nila class na sa gilabay nga mass nga ni kada mass m do ka buok ana. Okay, gilabay na kani string man siya, string kani siya kay mass, kay mass 1 same di sa mass, mass 1. So say nahitabo class na ay mass nya na apoy say radius nga dako kayo R1. So unsay nahitabo class, midako ni, diba? Midako imong I. Pero since naramo ka sa outer space class, ma-apply na ang conservation of angular momentum. So meaning initially ang imong H is just equal pod sa final nga kanang kuan, final pod nga angular momentum, diba? Namatay law of conservation of momentum. For linear lang to. Here for angular same magyapon. The angular momentum initially is just equal to the angular momentum at the final. Since equal man ta, so what happens is I initial W initial equals I final W final. Now, kung ang imuhang inertia sa final kay mudako, what happens? Di ba, ma-over man siya. Ma-over man ni IF. Ma-over man ni IF. So therefore, imong WF or the angular rotation is unsa man, di ba? They are inversely proportional. So meaning kung mudako ni si inertia at the final, mugamay ni si angular rotation or angular speed kaning final angular speed. That's why mo nang bugaton lang gamiton ilabay unya. Mag-torque ni siya, mo nang muhinay ni siya. So daghan kay application na class mo nang ilaning kuanan mag-employ sila ning technique. So mag-release sila duha ka mass nga patuyokon at a certain radius away from the space away from the rocket para ma-conserve ang angular momentum pero muhinay ang rotation kay dako naman iyang moment of inertia. So ano na, give and take, either si moment of inertia mo dako or si angular speed may mo dako, or si angular speed may mo gamay si moment of inertia mo dako. So yan na siya. And then let's go to the visualization of the angular kuan, angular momentum. So here matang ikon na ko ninyo. So take a look at this class. Kita argon ni nay usaka kuan skater. So nag-perform ng spin siya. So kita conservation of momentum, conservation of angular momentum that is angular momentum before is just equal to the angular momentum after. Ano sa may angular momentum before niya? That is just I W, and it is equal to, of course, after niya is more ni I prime W prime. But kung imo kita on class, kung atong kung kanang imong makuanan dire, hinay kay ang pagtuyok ngano man tungod kay dako iya moment of inertia kay gi-stretch man niya. Pero siguro kung kamo kung mag-spin pud mo class, gusto niya nga mupas pa siyag tuyok. Kung siya ang gibuhat class, iyan ang ginihinay og take off ni iyang kamot. Okay? And then iya gibutang sa iyang dughan. So since kay wa naman tay moment arm kay kanin contribute pian ni sa moment of inertia, meaning hindi decrease imo ang moment of inertia. So therefore our I prime here is less than I. So what it means that if we're going to find for the angular momentum after, so that would be I then W over I prime. Since si I prime daw kay gamay, what happens? Si W prime now or the angular speed after would increase kay mugamay man si I prime tuon kay iya mag-take off ang iyang kamot. So mao nang kung spin gay ka kani, gusto ka mo kusog ka, ayaw i-stretch mo ang kamot kay mahinay man gyud. Kung gusto po ka nga muhinay ka, mo slow down ka, imo na pud i-stretch og balik imong kamot. So kana siya nga kuan class activity ang nag-govern ana is ang angular momentum. So nakuha ra? I hope inyo nakuha. So let's try to solve some examples. So here, this is from the website on OpenStack. So here it states that a flywheel rotates without friction at an angular velocity of 600 revolution per minute on a frictionless vertical shaft of negligible rotational inertia. So kaning flywheel yang gipasabot kaning osa na sa figure. Kani siya nagrotate na siya. Let's say this is W equal to 600 RPM, kay revolution per minute. Then walay friction, so walay heat loss. A second flywheel which is at rest and has a moment of inertia of 3 times that of the rotating flywheel. So ang kaya din nag-rotate nga flywheel na siya inertia nga IO, so mo na siya. Ang usa nga at rest, so therefore this EW, let's say this is W1, this is flywheel 1, this is flywheel 2. So ang W2 is equal to 0 nga naman. Wa man wa manigatuyok pero na siya yung moment of inertia nga 3 IO. So 3 times the flywheel 1. And then gi kuan dai siya gibutang na is drop onto it. So kani second flywheel nga lihok gibutang sa first flywheel nga tuyok. Then because friction exists between the surfaces, the flywheels very quickly reach the same rotational velocity. Tod kanay friction pilit din siya nya nagdungan sa lang tuyok, same na ilang tuyok. And then after which they spin together. Then A, use the law of conservation of angular momentum to determine the angular velocity of the combination. So therefore we can say nga ni-stick man ni sila, so mura ba siya og kanang completely inelastic kung sa linear momentum pa. So we have here final angular speed nila duha, W prime. Then ikaduha is what fraction of the initial kinetic energy is lost in the coupling of the flywheels. Okay. Letter A. We're going to solve for the angular momentum after. So again, conservation of angular momentum, that is H before equals H after. Okay. Nasa may moment of inertia before. So before, natay duha, that is IO W1 plus 3IO W2 is equal to, how about after na? Since same raman sila og angular rotation, so we can just say IO plus 3IO dime W prime. Since W prime may pangita, so divide both sides by IO plus 3IO. Actually, ma 4IO na siya. So 4IO only. So this one is 4IO divided by 4IO. So cancel ni. What's left is I prime is equals to ati factor ang IO, then W1 plus 3W2 all over 4IO. Cancel ang IO. What's left is this one. W1 plus 3W2 global 4. So that is W1 is 600 RPM. How about W2? That is 0. So that is 3 plus 0 is 0 all over 4. So meaning W prime is just equal to 600 divided by 4. So that is 150. So ang pagtuyok nilang duha class is 150 RPM. So pangatay na class. Pangatay na. Okay ra. So ikaduha is kuan? Kinetic energy. So ang pangitan is ang kinetic energy. So for letter B, ang fractional kinetic energy nga na lost daw ko no. So here, ito lang ato sa na-erase. So for letter B, ato kanon since fractional kinetic energy mo nga loss, so F is equals to kinetic energy final over kinetic energy initial kay fractional man. So unsa atong kinetic energy initial? That is equals to 1/2 mv squared meno. But since we don't have linear velocity, but we can have velocity in terms of the angular speed. So that is 1/2 m, that's rw squared. And that would be 1/2 m, then r squared w squared. And since we know that mr squared is just the moment of inertia, so that is 1/2 io w squared. Okay, for initial, that is equivalent to 1/2 io, then w1 squared. Okay, si flywheel number 2, what si kinetic energy? Okay, nga naman sir, of course, kay waman siya nagkanang lihok. Meaning, si kuan ra, si flywheel number 1 ra. So, substitute, that is 1/2 IO niya, si W1 is 600 RPM squared. Meaning, ang kinetic energy initially is 1/2 times 600 squared. That is 180,000. That is 180,000 IO. But how about the kinetic energy on final? So, kinetic energy sa final, using this, so we can say that 1/2 IO, then W prime na siya. But here, ang moment of inertia is the combination of the moment of inertia na sa 1 o sa 2. So that is 1/2, that is IO for flywheel 1 and plus 3 IO for flywheel 2, then W prime. So that is 1/2 times 4 IO W prime. Sorry, that is equal to, kaya siya makancel ang 4, matunan na dili. That is 2 IO W prime. So balik ta diri sa F, kaning fractional part F, so that would be the final is 2IO, actually W prime na kuha natin gani ha, so ito din na erase no, and W prime is just 600 meter, 600 divided by 4, this 150, so W prime squared na siya, W prime squared ni. Okay, so that is 150 gani ha squared divided by kaning 180,000, that is 180,000 IO. So makanceling IO, so mara na mahabilin sila. So that is 2 times 150 squared divided by 180,000, the answer is 1/4 or 25%. So 0.25 or 25%. Mao na siya ang nakuan. Mao na siya ang na-lost sa pag-coupling. So 25% ang na-lost niya. So, lai pangutan na. Wala. Okay, let's proceed. So let's proceed sa last. Here, may siyang a bullet of mass 2 kilogram is moving horizontally with a speed of 500 meter per second. So kanisiya, as you can see in the figure, the bullet strikes and becomes embedded in the edge of a solid disc of mass 3.2 kilogram, so kaning disc, and a radius of 5 meters. The cylinder is free to rotate around its axis and is initially at rest. What is the angular velocity of the disc immediately after the bullet is embedded? So this is the figure, and then of course we have mass A, mass a disc, so MD na lang is 3.2. ang radius kay 0.5 meters. So required, kaya naman tayo mga figure and data. Required is the angular velocity of the disc immediately after the bullet is embedded, or silang duha kay kuan naman sa kay nag-usa naman sila. So that is W. Okay, the angular velocity of the disc. So unsay atong button niini? So kaneta conservation of momentum. So here unsay momentum aning siyempre nagkamay sila nagkanang nagdikit or nag-usa. So we can say momentum, angular momentum before is equal to angular momentum after. So again, ang angular momentum before is ang angular momentum sa bullet. Si bullet is kuan mo ni wa man siya angular momentum kay nagdagan niya siya, diba? Nagdagan man ni. And then the same thing with kuan, the same thing sa iyahang sana, the same thing sa disk. The same thing po sa disk. And then mas kilogram. Lagi. So kuan dai si disk maoy wala siya momentum before yung hit niya ang bullet. So therefore zero si disk. So ang dari angular momentum ani kay si kuan na si bullet. So ang angular momentum ni kanang ni bullet class is yang I sa bullet, then angular speed sa bullet that is equal to after na, since nag-embed naman sa duha. So that is I sa bullet plus ang I ha kay moment of inertia ni moment of inertia sa disk, then W nila, W prime. Okay, dungan man sila. So again, walay momentum, angular momentum ang disk initially ha, ngano man kay naghunong man eh. So ano ra angular momentum ani kay IW kay just before it hits gid exactly. Nya unsa may condition diri sa bullet pag hapit na gid siya mo tunong ba? Diba ang moment of inertia is just the mass of the bullet and the square of the R, then WB. That is equal to ID. Actually, ang ID day class, the mass moment of inertia for your information of a disk. Disk mo na sila. So ang ID is equal to 1/2 m r squared. So 1/2 siya. Don't worry, kaya ito na ma-discuss sa next mga topic. So IB is MB, then R squared, then plus ID is 1/2 MD, then R squared W prime. Since W prime itong ipangita, so kani siya. So divide both sides. Divide both sides by this MB R squared plus 1/2 MD R squared. So the same thing with the other side. That is MB R squared plus 1/2 MD R squared. So cancel this here. What's left is W prime. So W prime equals MB R squared WB divided by MB. Actually, yung factor na ito ang R squared. So that is R squared plus 1/2 MD. So ang factor ni para makancel sa osa. So what's left is mass sa bullet, angular speed sa bullet, all over mass sa bullet plus 1/2 mass sa kuan, mass sa disk. Okay. Ang pangutana po ani kay unsay angular speed sa bullet? Sa bullet man siya. So before mistake ni siya sa disk, ang iyang angular speed is iyang linear velocity divided by the radius of the disk. Kay naramo siya doon sa disk, di ba? Mura na siya mo approach nga mutuyok siya. So therefore we can say that the angular speed of the bullet is just the velocity, the linear velocity of the bullet divided by the radius of the disk. Kay kanang before pa siya gyud mistake ba? Di ba? Kay nag-ana man eh kung sa top view pa nag-ana ni siya. This is r, then nana siya, nana velocity vector nga kaning 500. Okay. So divide by r. So we can say that wb, that is mb, velocity b divided by multiplied by r, then mb plus 1/2 md. Okay, so plug in the values. So we have massa bullet is kuan 2 grams or in kilogram. I mean, naka-unsa din yung disk. If ang disk ay naka-kilogram man, so ato i-convert to kilogram, ang 2 grams. So 2 grams is 0.002, this kilogram. Velocity sa bullet is 500 meter per second, divided by the radius of the disk is 0.5 meters. So this 0.5. Massa bullet is 0.002 kilogram plus 1/2 massa disk is 3.2 kilograms. So that is 3.2. This is in kg. Ang kaning radius is in meters. So ang resulta ng answer kay kilogram makancel kilogram, then meter makancel meter. So ang answer nato is in radians per second. So that is 0.002 multiplied by 500 divided by 0.5 multiplied by 0.002 plus 1/2 times 3.2. Okay, the answer is 1.25 approximately 1.25 radians per second. Muna ayahang angular speed sa disk. So what is the angular velocity of the disk immediately after the bullet is embedded? So kanaan siya? Angular nila is 1.25 radians per second. Silang duha. Kaya nagdikit naman. So question so far. Wala pang utana?